Hey, we're bringing science down to Earth. What is this, Neil?
This is Wheel of Science.
Hey, everybody, I'm Chuck Nice. Welcome to our newest show, StarTalk's Wheel of Science. This is an interactive show where we answer your questions about the universe. And because I'm not smart enough to even answer my own questions about the universe, we have here to help out the one, the only, your own personal astrophysicist, Dr. Neil deGrasse Tyson! What's up, Neil?
What's up, Chuck?
As usual, you don't know the questions.
That's right. I'm sitting here clueless.
Aha, but I am positive that you know the answers. Our topic today is black holes.
Let's do this, bring it on.
Hey Neil, before we get into it, can you just let the people know, what is a black hole?
Black hole is a region of space where matter has condensed to such a high density that the gravity at its surface, the surface gravity, is so high that you cannot escape it, even at the speed of light. You are forever trapped. It is the fabric of the space-time continuum warped back on itself. And once you fall in, you are never coming out. It is the human version of the Roach Motel. You check in, but you don't check out. A black hole. That's why we call them black. And when you fall in, you don't come out, that's why we call it a hole. Because we tell it like it is in astrophysics. Black hole. Spin that wheel.
Daniel Junius wants to know, what happens when we fall into a black hole?
Ooh, you want to avoid that, first of all. Don't do that. Neither at home or at work or anywhere else. But if you happen to fall in a black hole, which is my preferred form of death, it's better than getting hit by a bus, right? So if you fall in a feet-first dive to this cosmic abyss, you will not survive because you will not miss. The tidal forces of gravity will create quite a calamity when you're stretched head to toe. Are you sure you want to go? Those tidal forces will increase to the point where your body will just snap in two, likely at the base of the spine. Then each of those two pieces will snap into two. So you become 1 to 2 to 4 to 8 to 16 until you bifurcate all the way down to the center of the black hole, and you become a stream of atoms. And that's not even the worst part. The worst part is you are funneled, extruded through the fabric of space-time, so that you used to be this wide, now you're this narrow. And so this phenomenon, this extrusion, like toothpaste through a tube, we have a word for it. Death by black hole is called spaghettification.
Spaghettification. Sounds like a meal to die for. See what I did there? Kill me. But give this video a like for a dad joke.
Chuck.
All right, Neil, you ready for the next one?
Spin that wheel.
Ivica Cern wants to know this. There is a black hole in the middle of our galaxy. Is there a giant black hole or something giant in the middle of our universe and something in the middle of the multiverse if we follow that logic?
No.
And that's all we have time for.
No, what do you want from me? It's a no. No. No.
But I'm sure there's more to it. What's up?
There is no center of the universe. All the universe was in the same place at the same time nearly 14 billion years ago. Then you could think of it sort of as a center. But after that, we are expanding and all pieces expanding away from every place else. It feels like we're at the center, but we're not. Any more than when you're a ship at sea and you are in the middle of your own horizon. You're equidistant from every edge of your horizon. That doesn't mean you're in the center of anything. So, no. There's no known center of the universe, and therefore I can say with some confidence there's no black hole there.
Okay, Neil, thanks for making me feel less important than I already do, knowing that I'm not the center of the universe. But wait a minute, how about black holes at the center of our galaxy?
We've got one, Andromeda's got one, except theirs is bigger than ours. We have black hole envy, but that's another show. Long ago, we didn't know if black holes would be common in the centers of galaxies with the help of the Hubble telescope, which has good, precise ways to look down in the center. Every galaxy we've had the capacity to check has revealed a black hole to us. Thus, we will extrapolate and assert that a black hole is a natural phenomenon in the center of all galaxies of the universe.
Neil, as usual, that's fascinating. We have time for one more question, and we're going to take a look at some group comments. But first, let's spin that wheel. Dan Birmingham wants to know, what's the most exciting thing we don't know about black holes?
There's good theoretical ideas about what would happen if you survive a trip through the black hole and come out on the other side. All of our equations tell us that an entire new space-time opens up for you. Once you've left the universe you were just in, you will never return to it, but you'll enter another domain. Our equations tell us it's there, but there's no way to test that and come back and tell anybody about it. So that remains, for me, one of the most intriguing mysteries of the universe. Is each black hole a universe unto itself? Chuck, back to you.
Damn, that is super cool. I'm gonna call that a black rabbit hole. Well, Neil, we are out of time. Thanks for being here, buddy.
Happy to be with you, Chuck, always.
Make sure you subscribe to StarTalk Network on Facebook Watch and join the Wheel of Science group and leave comments like Brian McReynolds, who says, I have just started sneaking science facts onto the dry erase announcement board at work, so this will give me some more ideas, LOL. Why don't you find Brian and leave him some facts, huh? Thanks for watching, guys. We'll see you next week on Wheel of Science.